CMUEagles.com with Central Methodist head women's basketball coach James Arnold as his team looks to resume conference play on Thursday, hosting Culver-Stockton at 5:30 p.m. inside Puckett Fieldhouse. Coach, your team coming off a decisive victory over Ottawa to start the new year. Just how happy are you to be back in the fold and back in a regular routine after having almost 3 weeks off?
Yeah, you know, the time off was good for us, though. We talked about, you know, kind of the semester break came at a good time as we were reeling a little bit with the loss of Kyra and trying to figure out as coaches and as players what our new identity was going to be and how we were going to adjust. And I thought we had some great practices over break. I thought that our effort against Ottawa was tremendous. And we've had to tweak a few things and do some things differently with our new identity. And I thought that was a great step in the right direction. Ottawa is a really solid ball club that could do some things that could hurt us, and we were able to negate those and also find our groove offensively, find a way to create some things, get some inside baskets, limit their offensive second chance points and things like that. So it was great to get that W. Now we get into league play, which obviously we're 0-3 in league play for the first time since I've been here. We're playing a team that is scrappy, well-coached, hard-working, and has some depth and some talent. So we're going to have our hands full to try to get this first league win of the year.
Unlike last year, Culver-Stockton enters this contest right with a lot of momentum, 9-3 overall. Culver-Stockton is a team that you've had a lot of success against in your time in Fayette, but it's a little bit of a different dynamic with a familiar face coming to town. Mm-hmm. Jeanette Burns is their head coach. Just speak to their success that they're having this year and the resurgence they've had under the former Central Methodist assistant.
Well, Coach Bergen is as good as they get, and we hated to lose her, but we were excited for the opportunity she had at Culver, and she's got them playing really, really well. They're 9-3. They beat a couple really good teams. They've taken a couple teams that aren't great and pounded on them, which is what you're supposed to do to teams that aren't great. They're coming off probably their best win of the year. Mount Mercy, who beat them early in the year by double digits. Jeanette and them and Culver beat them by 20-plus at home. So you're right. They're carrying a lot of momentum. They beat a good Graceland team on the road. They played well with Mid-Am for a while, and that got away from a little bit. The scary thing about Culver-Stockton is they're all juniors and sophomores. This group of freshmen and then sophomores have played together. Coach Bergen now in her second year. They've got a good system. They play hard. She's added a ton of depth. And they've got the kind of club that if one or two kids aren't having a good night, they can go to two or three more. They added the TJ Hart kid. They've added an extra big to Katie Davis to help her inside. Obviously, Randall Lee Plunkett, who was the freshman of the year 2 years ago, is now off the ball and is probably more efficient and more dangerous. So this is a ball club that plays hard. They play smart. They play together. They're just dangerous enough from the perimeter to be a threat, but really their paint touches are our main concern, both from their bigs as well as their guards can really get by you and get 2 feet in the paint.
Plunkett is their leading scorer, averaging a little more than 11 points per game. Definitely a player that's going to be on every team's scouting report when they play the Wildcats, but just allude to some of the things that she does well, especially since she's been moved off the ball.
Well, she's long, and as a long guard, she's able to raise up above you and get his shots, and so that's a unique ability that she has that a lot of guards at our level don't have. She also has kind of a herky-jerky motion to her game, and I mean that as a compliment in the sense that there's a lot of shots that she makes that don't necessarily look like they're makeable shots. They're tough twos, which can be very discouraging as a defender when you make a kid take a tough two and she makes it. She also draws a lot of fouls because of that. You throw in the Matthews kid who's back for her junior year that can really shoot it. Katie Davis, like I said, who averaged a double-double last year, who is either playing the four or even coming off the bench for them at the five this year. It's a much better basketball team. It reminds me a lot of the basketball team we had here with my second year with Coach Bergen, where we could come off the bench with Nakia's and come off the bench with Tawanda's and come off the bench with kids like that to make a big difference. And league play, night in, night out, having those extra players at that extra depth is really important.
This is a matchup last season in Puckett Fieldhouse that was not decided in regulation, had to go into overtime before Central Methodist eventually wore down Culver-Stockton. What do you think will be the keys to Thursday night's contest, and do you expect a similar type affair?
I think it's going to be very close. I think that regardless of the fact that Culver-Stockton's way better, and they are, and they're extremely poised this year and have a lot of momentum, I think the fact that with the type of team we have now, I think we're in good shape. I think we have a lot of wins in us, but I also think this is a different ball club than we started the year with, and we're going to have to grind to a lot of wins. I think it's going to be night in and night out going to be a dogfight for us, and we've got to adjust to that. So I'm hopeful that the practice we've had leading up to the game, I think, have been pretty good and have given us the kind of momentum that we need, both from that style of play, that dogfight, get out, work, every possession matters, get on loose balls, win the rebounding battle. But, yeah, I think it's going to be a tight basketball game. I think the keys for us are keeping them out of the paint, both post touches, because they have two really nice post players, and then another that can come off the bench. The fact that their guards are extremely athletic and can get around you and get in the paint. We fouled Ottawa a lot, and we've got to be ready to move our feet and not foul people in the paint. I think we're going to have to make some shots. If we make the shots from the outside, we've got a great chance. But I think for us, we've got to limit their, just like we talked about for our four keys over break, we've got to limit their second chance opportunities. We've got to get some easy basket opportunities, whether transition or post touches. And then we've got to get ourselves to the free throw line and keep them off the free throw line.